So, good evening, everybody. Today, I'm really privileged because I've got Ryan in the house again. Good evening, Ryan. How are you today?
I am very well, thank you. Very, very well.
And you're looking great as well.
Thank you.
That's all right. You're very welcome because I've been watching your progress over the last few weeks and you've come a long way.
Yeah, it does feel like that. Yeah, it does feel like that for definite. It really does.
And I want to say, because one of the things we were working with was well-being. Are you proud of what you've achieved?
Yeah, I'd say so, you know. I feel like I'm, what do you call it, I'm in a place where everything feels in alignment. So everything that I talk about, everything that I do, everything that I've got planned, it's all in alignment with me and my being. So I'm pretty happy, to be fair.
Excellent. Well done, though. And you know, I've been watching and observing at a distance, but for yourself, how do you feel like if someone was now starting off on a journey, a newbie journey, and I've got to come into a project, some projects you're doing in a moment, what would be the first step? Because, you know, we were talking about accountability last time we spoke. Okay. What would be the first step that you'd recommend that they do?
So if somebody wanted to start a business or, you know, in that particular context, I think one of the first things they need to understand is themselves. And they need to understand who they are as a person, because one of the reasons is that for your business to work effectively, you need to know what you have to bring to the table and what you've got inside you. And you'll also need to know who you serve as well. Once you know that, that's like the first part of building your business, because now you've got a purpose. There's a reason for you to, you know, start putting out content, because there's a purpose for your content.
Absolutely. Yeah, totally agree. And I think earlier we were talking about values. So sometimes it's the things that you've been through become the value that you're offering.
Yeah.
And, you know, if we can just do a general process at the moment, and this is general, obviously you can't generalize with everybody, but a lot of people going through life at the moment thinking that's bad, that's not good, that's gone wrong. And when you're focusing on that, basically it feels like you're gone sometimes into a deeper hole.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
So you feel as though you go nowhere, or you feel as though you're sinking, basically. So you often go to that feeling of despondency. You feel like you're not getting anywhere. You can start beating yourself up. You feel like life has gone off track. You can even start, you know, self-condemning yourself.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. And
I would say, sort of listening to what we were talking about earlier, as when you put in the value on that and you keep saying it's a problem, basically takes you away from who you're meant to be, doesn't it?
Yeah, I totally agree. You know, even though you're supposed to be in alignment with the things that you do, or, you know, the things that you for as well, it's almost the aspect of, don't do something, or it's not in the correct way, then I feel like I'm a failure somehow, because it's not like I've not done it. So yeah, I'm just not going to do it again. And that's what most people believe. They launch a business, but no one buys from them. No one engages with their content and stuff. And it's like, I can't do that. Yeah, speak for a minute. I can't do that in it.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think, you know, it goes in line with like power of attraction. Basically, what you're thinking about all the time is what you attract in.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah.
And one of the valuable things I learned very early on when I started this self-development and working towards the coaching is there is value in everything you've been through.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, definitely.
And if we can look at the lessons we've learned within these things that we've experienced, we can actually turn it into the value that we're offering other people.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. And it's that value that then you're putting out to the world.
Yeah. Yeah, that is a very true point. Because if you're projecting to people that, you know, you're giving up because you can't do something, then that almost becomes your reality in a sense.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
Absolutely. I think I heard it described in a book once. They said it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. If you say the world is not good, it's not good.
Yeah, true facts. Yeah, true facts.
If you're saying that I've messed up and you're focusing on that, you stay stuck in that space.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
And so for me, when I first start working with people, I would ask them to be honest. Honest with themselves. And we'd basically peel away the layers and start writing down exactly how you're feeling about things at the moment.
Yeah, that is always a good thing.
Yeah, absolutely. When you start downloading and you write it in front of you, you're getting a clearer picture.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. And I would say for anyone, you know, coming towards accountability, it's what we've got to talk about in a minute, is if you are actually in a space at the moment where you feel like everything's just gotten on top of you and you can see no way forward, take a little time out, get a journal or a little diary and write down how you're feeling today.
Yeah, most definitely.
Download anything and everything, even like the children are getting on my nerves today. And if that person speaks to me like that again, I've got to scream. Write all of those things down on paper and then we can look at it together and see how we can turn it around and see the blessings within what you've been through.
Yeah, totally agree.
And for a moment, I've got to take a moment, Ryan, just to say welcome to Emma. Good evening.
Thank you. Sorry, I was having Zoom trouble.
Oh, bless you. Okay. Well, we're having a little chat just talking about Ryan's business and how basically, if someone was stepping in to start something new in their lives, it's important to start downloading and recognising where you're at. So being honest with where you start, because a lot of that stuff is your foundation, it's your experiences that you've gained experience and wisdom from. And from there, we can start looking at where you want to go forward.
I love that.
Yeah. Okay. And I think, you know, from my own experience, and, you know, I've done it myself, I try to move forward, but I'm taking all that clutter with me. And the clutter is often the triggers that keep bringing us back to that place of, oh, this isn't working, or I've failed, or I've messed up again. And then we sit in that downward spiral again. And what would you suggest, Emma, if someone finds themselves keep repeating that downward spiral?
It's funny, I think me and Ryan spoke about this a little bit, didn't we, when we did our podcast. And it's the from the AA, and everybody knows it, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing and expecting different results. So just trying something different and stepping out there. And from what I see, Ryan, you step out there. And I love that. I love seeing your posts and they always bring me joy. And sometimes they bring me a bit of heartache for you as well, because I think you've got so many people behind you. You've got so much going for you. You really put across what you want and your passion, and I love that.
Yeah.
It's a great thing. Okay. I mean that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
that made me choke. You're great at giving compliments and supporting others, Ryan. You know, allow us to say, yes, you are a really good person. And you've inspired us all to make changes, because you had every reason in the world to not go forward with this. And you've taken it, I was going to say by something else, you've taken the horns and you've pulled yourself forward.
Yeah.
You've literally transformed your life.
Yeah, that's good stuff. Thank you.
Yeah, well done, Ryan. Okay. And, you know, I think for yourself, and I would say with anybody who's looking at this journey that they're about to take, stop, process, and praise yourself for every step you take. Because your mind and your body, your soul needs to hear that you are doing well. And it might be the smallest step of just downloading things into a book at the moment. It might be the smallest step of going, I'm going to choose to stop that thinking now. Your body needs to hear, your mind needs to hear that this is a step forward. It's something to celebrate. Don't wait until you do the big things, because those days are a little bit further away. If you celebrate the small wins as you go, you are opening up your heart, you're valuing yourself and the steps that you're taking. Really, it's such, you know, it's a small thing at the beginning, but you will start to see the power of it the more you praise yourself, the more you encourage and nurture yourself.
Yeah, most definitely.
And I think...
It's funny.
Yeah, sorry.
No, carry on, Dawn.
No. Please say what you've got to say, Emma.
No, I've downloaded, I've been listening to an audio book called Mother Hunger.
Yeah.
And that's a lot about nurturing, looking after yourself. And maybe I said to you, Dawn, like the little Emma inside. I don't know. That might have been Carol. But that praising the little steps that you take.
Yes.
And it's a big, big thing. And if you don't take those steps, it's not punishing yourself for it. It's seeing how you can do things differently to support yourself to get to that next step.
Yeah.
And it's quite an amazing book that I'm listening to. And it gives you a lot of hope and realization to your next steps.
Okay, excellent. Okay, lovely. So it's called Mother Hunger?
Yeah, by Kelly McDonald.
Kelly McDonald. Okay.
Thank it's you. A brilliant book.
Okay. So I'm going to put that on my reading list. Thank you. Because, you know, I think I spent the beginning of my coaching journey thinking I want to be there, but I didn't necessarily see the value of the little steps I was taking, because I'd been doing my wellbeing journey for quite a while. To bring a new concept of setting goals and all that into the picture completely threw me off track. It brought up some of my old patterns, some of my old inhibitions, some of those like, someone's judging me or someone's telling me what to do. And there was a major resistance. I think it took me a good few weeks to actually go, actually, this is for my own good. How do you find it when someone tells you, they're not telling you what to do, mm-hmm. but when you suddenly put onto a platform, for want of a better word, and people are watching you, how do you deal with that, Emma? Exactly, that was me. Anything was a good excuse.
I am open to anything in the world. I'll listen to any opinion. I will reason with anyone. If somebody tells me what to do, I recoil. And if somebody thinks that they know better, I recoil as well. I think you share knowledge of the world and not tell people. And it makes me feel inferior.
Yeah, absolutely.
Even if I know they know better than me.
And, you know, I think, Emma, from what we're saying, so I want to come to Ryan in a moment, because he's a man and I think he may have a different perspective. So I think that's good to balance out both sides. As I think we all have these triggers, which when we start something new, these triggers are going to become quite prominent in our mind. And it's these triggers that we need to be writing down, and we need to be sharing with our colleagues or someone that we choose for accountability. This is where Ryan has really helped me, as he helped me recognize the triggers. And it wasn't what he said, it was the fact the more I spoke about it, I start to realize the triggers for myself.
Mm.
And for me, and for anyone listening today, I would say, listen to what your triggers are, because if they keep repeating, you keep having this ongoing emotional seesaw of emotions. That's something for you to work with right now, because your soul is saying, I'm ready for it. Don't see it as a problem and push it down into your body. Because those demons become bigger and bigger, and they sit somewhere in your chakras in your body, and they will show themselves again later. It's better to be honest at the beginning and say, I am feeling this. How can I embrace it? What can I learn from it? How can I turn it around? And please don't be afraid to reach out and share this with somebody. Because when you're talking it through with somebody, hearing it, sharing it, and getting some feedback could be priceless in actually helping you to turn that around.
I completely agree, completely. Even saying some words out loud, you can think, I'm not so much I'm wrong, but that's not right. And just voicing things, just speaking to somebody can really, really help and change your mindset. Instead of it going round and round in your head.
Yeah, absolutely. And for me, I think the key words is how it makes me feel. And it's learning to listen more to how it makes me feel. So if I feel like I'm resisting, if I feel like I'm getting this gut reaction, I need to listen to that.
Yeah, most definitely. And yeah. I agree as well. One of the things that I normally do is, if I get those feelings or I get those thoughts, there's always a trigger point. There's always a root cause to it. So, you know, it's if you think to yourself you're not good enough to do a certain thing, and it's like, well, where did that come from? Like, what's happened for you to believe that? And so, you know, with everything in life, there's always a recourse. There's always a recourse to it.
Yeah.
Because nobody just says they're not good enough, or they can't speak on stage, or they can't do something in it. It's always because something else has happened to trigger how they feel. And so if, like Emma and Dawn said, if you just begin to talk to people and you talk it out, you may find that, you know what, I don't think I'm like that at all, bruv. I think I'm, you know, I'm legit. And, you know, I've got the confidence to now go and do other stuff. But like, if you keep that locked up, if you keep that balled up as well, it ain't going to end well. So yeah, just talk to someone, even if it's your mate, a coach, a counselor, therapist, even whoever it is, who take the time to listen to you, and give you that space to almost come to your own judgment, and that's the best person for you to be talking to at that point.
Absolutely. And thank you for sharing, Ryan. And I think as a man, you know, I want to say an extra well done, because a lot of men cannot face up to the fact that I've got this going on, because they bottle their emotions. Mm-hmm. And I've got to come to Emma in a moment. So they bottle up their emotions. It goes deep down in their body. It's somewhere within the pain. And they will turn often to something like alcohol to dampen that.
Yeah.
Or they'll get a bit more aggressive with it. They get a bit more macho, if that's the word I'm looking for. And that often distorts even more what they're experiencing, because they're just pushing it away from themselves.
Yeah, that's true. Okay. And for me, as a guy, as a man, it's been a, how would you put it? It's been a long journey to somewhat be able to share how I feel and my emotions, because society will look at as a man as strong. So even if like they're going through something in life, they have to have that persona that, you know what, everything's good, man. Everything's nice, innit? They can't show that that vulnerability side. However, damage comes for most men when they don't have a space to open up and they feel comfortable too. And that's one of the reasons why you see most men have mental health issues, because they feel that if they open up to people, then those people will have a different view. Like, I thought you were strong, but I thought you were a good person. How can you be so weak? Whereas if these people were to change how they think, it's a thing of, you know what? He's actually strong enough because he's taken the courage to admit his feelings, like, and to admit how he really, really feels. Yeah. So, I mean, for most men, it's always a struggle to open up. But once they've opened up, yeah, then you feel a lot more better, for it.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the word for me is coming up is find someone that you feel safe talking to. Don't go and do it down the pub where everyone's just got to add to the problem. Choose someone you feel safe or comfortable. You've got three people sitting here who would gladly listen and help you work through this. And just be honest with yourself. Just own what you're experiencing. It's not a sign of weakness. It's not a sign you've gone wrong. This is just an experience that you've had or experiences you've had. And today you're coming to this crossroads and I'm going to sit down and process this and work through it.
Mm, yeah.
Please don't beat yourself up for what you've been through, because that was what you went through with the experience and the knowledge you had. And, you know, the reason I'm so passionate about this is because I know some of the work Emma does and the experience she's had and the experience I've been through with alcohol, basically as the end result of me not listening to what my body was telling me, not listening to my own emotions and not wanting to own up what I was experiencing. I would push it down. I become quiet. I became withdrawn. But this anger was simmering inside me. And the doctor labelled it as depression. And from the depression state, I ended up with a ton of anxiety. So it became a vicious circle. It was through something pretty drastic, which Emma and I spoke about the other day when we were talking. I ended up passing out on the grass one day after I'd had one too many and woke up 3 days later with no knowledge of what had happened in between. And that was a wake-up call for me. And I would say to anyone listening, please don't wait till it gets to that crisis point. If you feel something stirring inside you and it doesn't feel in line with what you want to feel, please reach out. This is your time, because it's coming up for a reason, because your soul, your body and your mind has got what it needs within it to work through it and turn it around. And I want to come to Emma for the moment, and obviously, you see things at the other end, don't you, Emma, where you're working with people who've become consumed by addictions or something that they're using as a substitute for owning up to what's going on.
Yeah, it's funny. I was listening to Ryan speak and it made me think of people and stigmas, personas, and just firstly, I'm speaking to somebody later and she's got thousands of followers.
Yeah.
And I thought, what right have I got to be interviewing her, yeah, when I haven't got the thousands of followers? And again, that's put myself down and I should not do that. That's a barrier to me becoming more successful and helping more people. And also with what Ryan said, with this, the stigmas and stuff, it brought up things in me, emotions like rugby players that can't say that they're gay because it's a hard sport, and it's our world is full of this, and mental health stems from these stigmas and trapping people and keeping them down. And it doesn't matter what color or sex or anything that you are. If you've got a talent, if you are a human being on the earth, you deserve to live your best life. It doesn't matter who you are or what you do. If you're living your best life, you go and do it. And and this is where alcohol and not simple things, but people can take paracetamol, or there's so many things that people do to try and suppress who they are and what they are feeling. And it's a sad world like that.
Yeah, it's sad, because I think there's still this a bit of shame to admit that I'm not coping with life. And why should that be? Why should we assume there's some shame with it? Because we do. It's like I feel embarrassed because I'm not coping very well. I see all these other coaches exploring this world and they're doing great, and actually I've messed up. Why is it so hard to step up and say that? I think a lot of the time we worry what other people think about us. We're stepping into owning territory because we judge us. And we play this game in our head, which says, blah, 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 blah. And what if it isn't true? What if what we're actually saying outwardly is basically what we're condemning ourselves with?
I think that's the funny thing, that there's people that are in so much control. Police officers, judges, prime ministers, whoever, really high pressured roles, and they take to tablets, alcohol, whatever it is to cope, but we don't see it.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're sheltered from all that. And it's because of those high pressured roles, and not that I'm saying that they need it. But we don't realise that our life is in the hands of many people that have probably got problems that some of us think are really major and we want to sort out, and they find it as a coping strategy for everyday life.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. And, you know, I think we've all come to that moment in our life where we realise things have become muddled. It's become confusing, it's become irritating, and you can feel it in your body somewhere. And some of us will reach out and grab a bottle, some of us will take some more pills, some of us will just pretend it's not happening. But I will say to you now, regardless of how you try to push it away from you, it will come back. And it is impacting on how you feel today. Because every thought you're having creates a neurological response in your body, which creates how you feel. And if that doesn't feel right today, because you're not feeling your what you call your contented self, please, let's own up. Let's do it together. Let's do it as a group. Let's do it as a family. Let's come together, put our hands up, own what you're experiencing, and let's find out how we can help you. So sending that thought out, so some people will sit and pray about it. Some people might need to meditate. Some might just write it down or pick up the phone and say, help. And reaching out to somebody is the first sign that you are ready to take steps forward and own your accountability for your well-being. It's not just about the mental mind and the physical body we've gone through. It's your soul. And Ryan and I were talking earlier about bringing more spiritual development into the repertoire. That's what, you know, where Ryan's going at the moment is bringing in the whole picture. It's like, it becomes a way of life when you embrace all that you've been through, all that you've experienced as part of who you are. It's not your weaknesses. This is now your strength.
It makes you unique.
Yeah, yeah it does.
Mm, yeah.
Absolutely. And, you know, obviously we can't pick you off one by one, but if you're watching this today and go, yeah, I can recognize what they're saying, I can relate to what Ryan said, I can relate to what Emma said, pick up the phone, because this says that your soul is saying this is your time to turn it around. Become accountable for your well-being, and believe me, that sense of relief that you feel when you've made that call or sent that message out, it's going to be priceless, and it will turn your life around. And we'll be glad to help you. Honestly, Ryan, I know we can find you on Facebook.
Yeah, you can find me on Facebook. If you have a LinkedIn page as well, you can find me on LinkedIn as well.
Yep.
But I'm more active over on Facebook, so. Yeah, find me on Facebook, drop me a message.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can have a chat. We can have a conversation.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you. Thank you, Ryan. And thank you for sharing with us tonight. I really, really respect and appreciate that. Thank you. And Emma, where can we find you, love?
I am Evolve Recovery, and I'm on Facebook. My website is familyrecovery.co.uk.
Okay.
And just anybody struggling, just as we've said before, just that simple email that won't be simple, but it could just say, can we talk? Can we connect? That is, I'm covered in goose pimples. That is a huge step, and it can lead to a lot of release.
Absolutely. I feel this massive sense of relief actually that we've come together, because I think this is the beginning of something very important. There's a lot of people out there stepping into the unknown, and they don't know what to expect, so they will withdraw again. And I would say, for me, the remedies, the backflow remedies, were what I turned to. So aspen helps with the fear of the unknown. And century, which is another remedy, helped me when I made my mind up to do something, but I have this really annoying habit of pulling back, so I don't always follow through on what my intention was. And century helps to create new boundaries. And I would say to anyone out there, there is a combination of remedies, there is a combination of coaching, there's a combination of NLP, which will help you today. I promise you, you are not on your own. The world is waiting for you and your message. So please reach out today. Thank you very much, Emma. And thank you, Ryan, for joining us today. And I shall look forward to next time. Thank you.
John, that's beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.